Alright guys, today we're going to look at the International Cummins X15 engine. We got an error code that we kept getting on this thing, so we figured out what the error code was and how to fix that. So let's dive into that. So here's our X15 engine. So the error code we keep getting is actually coming from right down here. Just past the turbo, you have your NOx sensor, your NOx sensor. And so that's what we keep getting the error code from. And so what we ended up doing is we had some problems with our actuator. Our actuator wasn't closing all the way, and then it got stuck closed. So we had some issues there. So the NOx sensor was trying to tell us that, hey, this has an issue. After we changed the actuator, we had to put new parts in there. We had to go back, and we kept getting the error for this NOx sensor. So we went ahead and removed that and replaced that. Now, in order to get that, let me zoom in here and show you. So a lot of guys are having a lot of problems getting this off because this is steel and this is cast iron. And so because of the heat of this, it almost seals these two together. So you have to have a special tool. I would not recommend using anything other than what I'm going to show you right now, just because you're going to round this over and it's going to be a nightmare to get out. So what we'd like to use is this tool right here. It's 7/8 here. It's got a slot, and then you put your wrench on right there. The reason why I recommend this is because it's specially made for these NOx sensors. So you can even see on here, this says it's a 7/8, 22 millimeter sensor, oxygen wrench is what this says. And so this is what I encourage you if you're gonna change out this NOx sensor yourself. When you change a NOx sensor, you have to change the whole cable. Now this cable runs down, there's a plug-in down below that you have to unplug, you take the whole thing out, you replace it. It's a very expensive sensor. Once we got the new sensor on there, we went ahead and fired the engine up, made sure all the clothes were clear. We've driven it for a couple days now, and that error code has not came back. Just wanted to show you that. This tool is going to be your lifesaver when you're dealing with this. So there you go. There's our NOx sensor, and we cleared our code, and we're all good to run now.